everyone. How are you doing tonight? My name is Andrea. I'm the maid of honor. Sunmarie and I have known each other for quite a while, since we were girls. And as girls do, we always wondered what our husbands would be like, what marriage would be like. So when Sunmarie told me that it would be Seung kook, that would be the man she would marry, I was very curious not only to know what he would be like, but what their relationship would be like, what their marriage would be like. So fast forward a couple of months to a workshop that we both attended for young couples on their way to marriage. And Sunmarie and I were sharing a room. And one night it got very late and she hadn't come back to the room yet. And I thought, where is she? Well, I don't know, I'm feeling tired, so I'm gonna go to bed. So I went to bed, but the next morning I confronted her and I said, Sunmarie, where were you last night? You didn't get back till well after I went to bed. And she said, oh yeah, I didn't get back till about 2 a.m. 2 a.m.? What were you doing till 2 o'clock in the morning? Well, I was with Seung kook. You're with Seung kook. What were you doing with Seung kook until 2 o'clock in the morning? And she said, well, you know, we were taking a long walk and we were talking about all sorts of things and we were holding hands. And you know, I didn't doubt her for 1 minute. Sunmarie and Seung kook have always had this beautiful, pure and innocent connection with one another. And their love has always been pure and beautiful and rooted in friendship and companionship. And I know that it's their love and their faith in God that will get them through all of life's challenges, anything that life throws their way, and keep them together forever. So may your hands be forever clasped in friendship and your hearts joined forever in love. To Sunmarie and Seung kook.
Forever could never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted in my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will.
Everybody.
Yeah, I did.
Okay, so I've known Seung kook for most of my life and all of his life, so I feel okay to do this. So I was thinking about something. I crumbled my paper. I was thinking about something Sunmarie told me about a few months ago, and she was telling me about asking Seung kook a question. And she asked Seung kook, what is it like to have a brother? And then she told me, Seung kook said, it's like having a lifelong competition. And I was like, what? And then I thought about when I was little, and how Seung kook had no friends. And how my mom and my dad would always be like, hey, take Seung kook with you. And so I felt pretty good about myself. But then I started thinking about this competition a little bit more. I'm like, man, he's always been smarter than me. He's always had better grades than me. He's always like in the smarter classes, I was in the dumber classes. He like He got like a motorcycle when he was 17 years old. He was buying and selling cars when he was in high school. He joined the track team, the volleyball team, and then pushed me to go on the track team and volleyball team. And then I was thinking like, man, he's like so much better. He's winning this competition. And I don't know, it was just something I was thinking about. And I was like, man, Seung is like always so driven. Whenever he has his mind on something, he always like goes after and gets whatever that's on his mind. And I started to think like, man, I felt like he was always the one in the family within the siblings that was like raising the bar, that was setting the standards. And I felt like bad, like I'm like, that should be my job, I'm the older brother. But I always felt like he was the one that was raising the standard, that was really pushing himself and pushing us while he was pushing himself. And that's something I've always admired and respected with Seung Kook. And, but, there was one thing that I was better than him at. And that was, I was more fun than Seung Kook. Right? I was always more fun than Seung Kook. If you guys knew Seung Kook before, he was always like stone-faced and super intimidating. Like, girls would never talk to him. He was so serious and scary. And I think that's why Sunmarie is perfect for Seung Kook. Because Sunmarie is so cute. She's so silly. And she shares the funniest stories. Like, she always has the funniest things ever happen to her. And I feel that's what's great about this relationship right here. Seung Kook always does what he sets his mind to, but you don't just, that's not what life's about. It's not just about accomplishments. It's about that journey and enjoying that journey. And I feel that's what Sunmarie gives to Seung Kook. Even though he sets his mind to something, Sunmarie is there to be able to have him enjoy the journey. Seung Kook's always making like green smoothies and like trying to be healthy. And Sunmarie's like, I want ice cream. And that's what makes it perfect. You know, we can't just be drinking green smoothies all the time. I need ice cream.
No ice cream.
So I want to give a toast to Eternal Journey! Yeah.